Do you believe Jose Rizal is the father of two further important figures in world history, with those figures being the German for Adolf Hitler and the Japanese general Tomoki Yamashita?
Po what?
If you are new in my channel, please subscribe, like, share, and hit the bell to notify more videos. Welcome to Neltoons TV. History Revisited, 1st January 2011. This research is credited to the author anonymously known as Vidimus. I don't know him or her, but I believe his noble research and I feel it is authentic because my vibration direct me to this piece of work to know the truth that I never learned since I was in school. Certain names have loomed large in the history of the Philippines over the past 100 years. Without being unjust to those who made a meaningful contribution to the independence and autonomy of the Philippines, it can be fairly claimed that the names which have attracted the most public attention are those of Jose Rizal, Ferdinand Marcos, Tomoki Yamashita, and perhaps Don Esteban Benitez Tolano. Everyone has their own story to tell of the good work of Rizal in terms of his patriotic writing, of Ferdinand Marcos and martial law, of Tomoki Yamashita and his buried treasure, and of course the Tolano clan and their claim as true title holders of the original Spanish land title known as October 1-4. The writer of this article holds that those four names are universal conversation pieces in the Philippines, and few evenings pass that one or another is not mentioned in conversation with friends and associates. One would imagine that with such names being universal conversation pieces, that nothing in their life has been spared intense scrutiny, and that there is nothing yet to be revealed about their respective lives. If there is nothing yet to be revealed about their lives, then please explain, among other mysteries, A. where one would find the grave of Rizal, and B. why are there no Japanese visitors to the shrine for Tomoki Yamashita? Of course we shall need a starting point, and because it bears relevance to what we investigate, we choose as our starting point the birth of Queen Victoria of England on 24th May 1819. Now the published story of Queen Victoria's birth at Kensington Palace was not entirely accurate, even though she did reach the Kensington Palace on the same day as her birth. In fact, she arrived in this life somewhat earlier than expected, while her mother, Princess Victoria of Saxe-Coburg-Saalfeld, was aboard a Dutch ship in the English Channel, near Dover, as she sped to meet up with her husband at Kensington Palace for the expected birth. That variation between published fact and reality was simply to preserve the concept of born on English soil on behalf of a woman destined to become the future Queen of England. Again, what is not published but is widely known within the establishment of England is that Queen Victoria was one of twins and had a brother. That boy was, in all probability, autistic, a condition little understood at the material time, and the courtiers decided that he was unsuitable to be raised in the precincts of the court, and while every facility possible was placed at his disposal, he was kept separate from the court and educated privately. Note: the Lion of Scotland and the name MacLeod, the badge of North Borneo Company. In his late 20s, the young man, brother of the Queen, moved to Borneo, then known as the Dutch East Indies, and became entranced with the life, adventure and business opportunity offered by that country. In conjunction with Baron von Overbeck, he formed and became chairman of the North Borneo Company, which engaged in exploitation of the natural resources of that country. His name, he was known as Prince Julian MacLeod Tolano. Being of princely bearing, well educated and clearly wealthy, he was introduced to a number of eligible women, and eventually became enamored of, and married, the Princess Tahata. Mark now that North Borneo was Muslim territory, and in taking his Muslim wife, Prince Julian MacLeod Tolano converted to the Islamic faith, thus fusing the religious affiliations of both his motherland and Borneo, as he was a prince of the royal blood. Likewise, that marriage interwove the fortunes of the two distinct clans of differing faiths. Tolano, as a Muslim, acquired 7 wives but still maintained the libertine pursuits of his early life. His pursuit of another princess and their liaison beyond marriage produced a male child. With connivance of the Catholic Church, a means was found to provide for welfare of the child. Today one hears many stories of the orphan found in a basket outside the home of the Mercado family in Calamba, Laguna Province, about 50 kilometers south of Manila. The boy was raised by the Mercado family and given the name Jose Protasio Mercado. The child grew and proved to be extremely intelligent. He was incredibly active and wanted to be the best at all he undertook. He referred to himself as Rexal, the king of all, which name soon became adapted to Rizal, and so we have Jose Protasio Rizal. The child had been well provided for in terms of money, and while it was unusual for the times, he went to Madrid to study, since he was proficient in the Spanish language. Spain caused him to reflect on the number of blind persons in the population, and he determined to become a doctor with specialty in the eyes. He chose to study under a particular professor and went to Paris to join the classes of that professor, but found that the professor had moved to a university in Heidelberg, Germany. He followed to Germany, mastered the German language, and eventually took his medical degree in 1886. As a doctor, he now sought patients. There was resistance to eye surgery because few chose to allow anyone to operate on their eyes, but one young student at Heidelberg University was desperate to have her eyes corrected, and so that student, Josephine von Bracken, became the first patient of Jose Rizal. The operation was a success, and Josephine Bracken very quickly introduced her uncle, the King of Prussia, Wilhelm I, favorite grandson of Queen Victoria, then German Emperor, at Potsdam, near Berlin, who had similar eye problems. Again, the operation was a success, and the fame of Jose Rizal as an ophthalmologist was assured. The Emperor of Germany, grateful for the work of Rizal, dedicated the Asian Tea House in his honor, which tea house is now a popular tourist attraction in the castle of Sanssouci. The Emperor further recommended Rizal to his relative, the Emperor of Austria. Rizal arrived in Austria in 1887 and was introduced to a Jesuit priest, Father Ferdinand Blumentritt, who had recently arrived from the Philippines, where he conducted a Jesuit school on the island of Cebu. Since it was considered that the emperor may take some time to consent to the intended operation, Father Blumentritt invited Rizal to stay in his apartment. In a near apartment was a young lady, Clara Poelzl, who was a staff member of the emperor's household. A liaison between Jose Rizal and Clara Poelzl, who was the wife of Alois Schickelgruber, produced a male child, later named Adolf. The husband, Alois Schickelgruber, suspected that another man was responsible for the pregnancy of his wife, and he severely mistreated the child. Blumentritt decided that to avoid further mistreatment of the child, he should take the boy to Cebu, and the mother readily agreed because she knew that Rizal would be there. And so Adolf Schickelgruber, as the boy had been named, came to the island of Cebu in the Philippines, where he was raised and educated. Yes, it is the same Adolf Schickelgruber. Adolf Hitler. Adolf Hitler was the son of Jose Rizal, via Clara Poelzl. If you ever have the opportunity to visit the library at Malacanang, note as you enter the huge portrait of Jose Rizal. Then turn 180 degrees to see a smaller portrait of Adolf Hitler staring across the room at his father. It goes without saying that those who plotted the financial strategies in Malacanang were comfortably aware of the relationship between Rizal and Hitler, and the portraits are testimony to their arcane knowledge. With his fame spreading, Rizal went to Japan to perform an operation on the eyes of the emperor, and once again, a dalliance with a Japanese noblewoman, the Princess Keiko, produced a male child. The Tenno himself wrote to Rizal and warranted that he would educate the boy in the very best schools, and so the second son of Jose Rizal would attend the finest colleges in England, and ultimately become the highest-ranking general in the Imperial Japanese Army, General Tomoki Yamashita. Meanwhile, the first son of Rizal was at the Jesuit school in Cebu, and saw his father only at those fleeting times that he was able to make a visit. It is considered that the reported situation of Rizal's exile and deputant being sentenced to death and executed by firing squad in Bayambayan, now Rizal Park, Manila, is indeed extraordinary, highly improbable, questionable, and in view of the value of his surgical prowess beyond reason. How could a man, known as an idol and hero to Filipinos, friend of kings and emperors, highly intelligent and speaking 12 languages, be ordered killed by the much-hated friars, and shot by 21 Guardia Civil, his countrymen, in Manila in 1896? If we look back 100 years to that incident, we should also look to the famous Battle of Manila Bay, beautifully painted and depicted in many written words and monuments, but which never took place. The Spanish ships had surrendered before the cannons of the American ships were unleashed to fire in the air. It is reported that one American died in his cabin of the heart attack. In that context, we pose again a question mentioned in opening paragraphs of this essay. Please point out the location of the grave of Jose Rizal. History records that the Americans who won the war paid US$20 million to the Spanish losers of the war. Quite apart from being a lot of money at the time, it would have to be the first and only time in history that the winners paid a bounty to the losers of the war. To set the record straight, the Americans are claimed to have paid the sum of US$20 million to the Spanish, but it can be shown that the sum of $20 million was subscribed by the Magnificent Seven through a mortgage loan from Banco Español Filipino in Bindo. Observe annotation 72S2-6-1898 on the October note 1-4, which quote secured by this title October note 1-4 Hacienda Mabaigu embracing the province of Pampanga, Culiat, the whole of Bamban ABD Capuz Tarlac has mortgaged to the Banco Español Filipino the sum of US$20 million to undertake the payment of succession treaty between Spain and America for the ceding of the archipelago by the Spanish government to the American government be eventually reverted to the real landowner Don Esteban Bain Castellano. Date of inscription February 7, 1898. Signed, Fermín Jordans y Álvarez ad, Interim Governor General, Royal Crown of Spain, end quote. That loan by Banco Español Filipino was repaid within 1 year, and a further annotation to the October note 1-4 demonstrated the means by which the money was assembled, quote. Entry No. EDC 073S2-6-1898, Real Estate Mortgage AMOUNTNG to US$20 million secured by this land title T1-4, embracing the area of Hacienda Mabaigu, Pampanga, Culiat and Capuz Tarlac to Banco Espanol Filipino has been cancelled, and this released forever of real estate mortgage has been executed by the bank in favor of the owner WTH the full payment of said principal loan and an interest of US$2,200,000, the payment of which has broken as follows. General Miguel Malvar correspondingly acquired the area of Tanyuan, Batangas and had paid the amount of US$3,300,000. Don Servilano Aquino acquired the whole area of Bamban and Capuz Tarlac and correspondingly paid US$3,300,000. General Antonio Luna acquired the whole San Miguel, Tarlac and La Paz, Tarlac and he paid US$2 million. The land was given as a gift to his girlfriend Miss Lucita Cuanco. Don Mariano Tig acquired the area of Culiat and Mabaigu, 1,500 hectares Pampanga, and paid US$3,300,000. Don Francisco Macabulos acquired the area of Stagnacha, Tarlac and paid US$2,400,000. Don Juan Ayercito acquired absolutely the San Juan del Monte Hacienda embracing up to Sitio Mandaluyong consisting an area of 3,154 hectares and had correspondingly paid US$3,300,000, and Don Esteban Benitez Talanotagin maintained his rights being the owner over the unacquired estate and had paid the balance of US$6,600,000. Date of inscription February 7, 1898, signed Benito Legarda, ad interim land registrar, end quote. In short, historical records demonstrate conclusively that succession from the Spanish was purchased by Don Esteban Benitez Talano Tejon, and clearly that arrangement had been reached several months prior to the May 1898 purported date for the Battle of Manila Bay. The only conclusion that can be reached in the light of such evidence is that any Battle of Manila Bay was a staged performance as opposed to an act of war or aggression. In that same context, we can conclude that the purported execution of Rizal was an equivalent pantomime, and history would repeat itself 48 years later, with the purported execution at Los Banos, Laguna, of General Tomoki Yamashita. No Japanese national will ever accept that General Yamashita surrendered to the Americans. A Japanese general of the highest order, and with connection to the royal household, will never surrender. Such a general is bound by the code of honor of his calling, and must commit harakiri, the ritual suicide signifying failure. Thus, whoever is buried at Muntinlupa, south of Manila, that body is not the body of General Yamashita. We do not speculate on the escape, whereabouts or post-war activities of General Yamashita, but our hypothesis that he was not the victim of the gallows designed to dispatch him is reinforced by the fact that no Japanese national pays homage at the shrine to General Yamashita, for the very good reason that every Japanese national knows that his surrender was impossible, and that some undefined politically inspired pantomime has played havoc in obscuring the true course of events. There are rumors that during his time at the English universities that Yamashita became the lover of Lady Elizabeth Bowes Lyons, a beautiful debutante, which liaison continued after her marriage to Albert, the then Duke of York. As the fates ordained, Albert, a sickly man who never expected to become king, was thrust into that position as King George VI when his elder brother Edward VIII abdicated the throne in order to wed his paramour, the twice-divorced Mrs. Wallace Simpson. The remarkable aspect of the affair between Yamashita and Lady Elizabeth Bowes Lyons, if it has substance, is that the present Queen Elizabeth II could well be a daughter of General Yamashita, and therefore, a granddaughter of Jose Antonio Rizal. So let us now summarize what we have constructed from a more pragmatic view of the stated history of the Philippines, at least in terms of reviewing the impact on what has been referred to as the hidden wealth of Marcos. Prince Julian MacLeod Talano, brother of Queen Victoria, is the father of the man later known as Jose Rizal. Thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel Nulltoons TV.